We don't need to compete with each other. We don't need to make each other feel guilty. We all do need to be responsible. And I think that my little jaunt into the term black or the term slavery, for me, is about sharing with you some ideas about how we take forward what it is we wish to achieve. Black History Month was not created in order that we might compete with each other about who's the most oppressed. It's a competition, frankly, that you can't judge, never mind win. If every life is important, then how can we say that these lives are more important than those lives? Either every life is important and of equal value, or none are. A series of wrongs have been done historically to a whole series of peoples in this world, and we don't need to get into competition about which is the worst. They're all wrong, and our responsibility, surely, looking forward, is to ensure our own actions don't lead to the genocides that we have seen and are seeing. Thankfully, I'm not going to speak for the entire 40 minutes. You'll be delighted to hear. But I would like, I've got one more point to make, but I would like questions, if you want, and I'm happy to answer questions. But I want to end by saying something about where the law is now, where the law's likely to be. We're going to have a Single Equality Act. It's going to make it unlawful for discrimination to occur because, and then we'll have a list of categories of experience. I hope it includes class, although I have to tell you, I'm not going to hold my breath on that one. I think it might take many of us to get together to say the class or economic status or whatever words you want to use that you are may have a bearing on how you're treated, and you may be treated less favourably. It's an important point, you know, because these days, in the days of equal opportunity, I've seen many organisations rush to recruit very rich and prosperous, privately school educated, people of African origin or Asian origin to make up the numbers or to get the quota. There's no quota in this country that's lawful, but to make sure they've got the composition looks different. And I'm not convinced myself, I am not convinced that we aid the delivery of our services to ordinary people by having black people who know nothing about the community provide those services, when in fact it might be better to have a white person who knows the community, who lives in the community, to deliver that service. I think we need to move away from colour for its own sake. But as we move forward to embrace what will be an extension of our rights to be free from discrimination, I think that we need to look very closely at what we have in common. Instead of, currently there are six categories of disadvantage, that recognise that people might be discriminated because of their religion or their beliefs. They might be discriminated because of their disabilities. They might be discriminated because of their gender, because of their race or ethnicity. What have I left off? Because of their age. Gender? I've said gender. I think I've got all six. That's the one. That's the one always gets missed off. Or because of their sexual orientation. That list may be extended. The danger is we start competing with each other as to who's going to be heard the first, who's going to be heard the loudest. I think the danger of that is that this country is very, very good at dividing rule, and they would love to see some of the people who occupy power would love to see us squabbling with each other rather than looking at what we have in common. And remember that in every community, at least 15% of every community is disabled. that 52% of every community is female. We can go on and on. So anyone who thinks these categories sit in isolation from each other is in cloud cuckoo land, because in the real world, we are always more than one of those categories to tick. Always. So I think that we need to prepare ourselves looking forward to an equality that respects every human life and is able to listen to the differences without being threatened, is able to be respectful of the histories that many communities have endured, not in silence, but by being marginalised. Black History Month, when we started it 21 years ago, it was right then, I think it's right, to look more broadly, not to forget African history, but to see African history sitting alongside the histories of all of the peoples who have been ignored and marginalised in this country. The great place that we love, this country, and I suspect most of us are not here for the weather. We're here because actually this is a good place to be, a place we choose to be. So let's all of us learn in a respectful way about each other so that we can create, I suppose, partnerships, support, and really transform this society so that everybody is respected and has a safe place to be in this country. Thank you.